From the studios at Brentwood High School, you're watching award-winning WBHS 9 News with Aubrey Mullicky, Makai Payne, reporters Avery Allen, James Gill, and Brett Michelson. WBHS 9 News starts now.
Hello, Brentwood High School. I'm Makai Payne.
And I'm Aubrey Mullicky. Here's what's making news. Brentwood Middle is starting a groundbreaking renovation to help accommodate the growing population. Brett Michelson has more.
Brentwood Middle School is getting some exciting new additions in the next few years. They are starting a multi-phase plan to construct a new building to help with the rapidly growing population. Board members voted on the new additions coming to Brentwood Middle.
Resolution of the Williams County Board of County Commissioners, approval of an intent to fund for 28 for improvements and new construction at Brentwood Middle School.
Along with various improvements, this will also expand the capacity of Brentwood Middle School from 1,200 to 1,500 students.
If you're in favor, press your yes button. Opposed, your no. Resolution passes.
Many people, especially students, are excited to see a new and improved and modernized Brentwood Middle School. Brett Michelson, WBHS 9.
In sports, Brentwood plays Father Ryan away after a victory against Blackman.
This school year has brought along new rules that will affect both students and staff. James Gill with more.
This year, administration has designed new rules and regulations to help create a better environment for both students and teachers.
Couple of the new rules that we incorporated for the 22-23 school year was parking passes. And the reason that we incorporated that was to save time instructionally. A lot of times when students would, for example, leave their lunch in their car or have a textbook that maybe they left in the car, they would have to seek out an administrator and then go to their car. So we tried to prevent lost time, and we have it where every teacher now has the ability to let students go to their cars. We looked at some of the systems, and some of it was for protecting instructional time for our teachers and students. And again, it goes back to safety and security. We wanted to make sure that when students are not in the classroom, that we kind of know where they are. And this, I think, system allows us that opportunity to provide oversight to know where all our students are.
Dr. Moe, along with the rest of the administration, will be working to keep Brentwood a safe space for everyone. James Gill, WBHS 9.
Coming up, a look into the new grading scale.
And more on AP fees after this break. Big changes are coming to the district's grading scale. Avery Allen tells us what to expect.
Next item is 4.600 report cards and grading systems.
The Williamson County School Board met on August 15th to decide if the district will adhere to Tennessee's new grading scale. The new 10-point scale passed unanimously and will take effect this school year. Superintendent Jason Golden explained the benefits of the new grading system.
Thank you, Mr. Chair. On July 22nd, the State Board of Education passed a policy regarding grading systems and changed that structure to a system that was slightly below our current structure from a structure that was slightly above our structure but had the exact same grade for an F. Based upon their dropping the F standard 10 points from a 69 and below to a 59 and below, we need to change our grading policy so that our grading system is consistent with theirs when they evaluate a student for the Hope Scholarship.
Area school districts, including Metro Nashville and Maury County, have already implemented the new system. More students will qualify for the Hope Scholarship and other out-of-state scholarships and tuition aid. Grades for previous years will not be recalculated to the new grading scale.
The old grading policy will apply until this change, so they are still under the old policy for any grades that were recorded last year and earlier.
The state's previous grading scale is as follows. It varies slightly from the previous district scale, where an A began at a 91. Students' GPAs have historically been calculated in both the district scale and the state scale on student transcripts. Now, the state and district scales will match, with an Abe getting at 90.
What I described earlier with the F dropping 10 points, it was most appropriate for us to align our grading scale to the state.
The passage of the new grading system will allow for a more efficient process for reporting GPAs. Avery Allen, WBHS 9.
Thank you. Motion passes.
If you're taking any AP classes this year, your fees must be paid by Friday, October 7th. An additional late fee of $40 will be charged per exam.
Thank you for joining us. I'm Makai Payne.
And I'm Aubrey Mulliken. See you next time on WBHS 9 News.